Greetings, this is Brad from the Cheese Shop. We're at the nearing the very end of our GURPS character creation video series, and in this video I'm going to be talking about skills. Now, skills are something that you would roll against when you're playing, you know, during the adventure or the campaign. To give you an example, the GM might actually tell the player, you know, to make some sort of acrobatic roll. You would roll against your acrobatic skills or default if you actually did not have that skill. And this section will talks about specifically what it takes to purchase that skill, and then also what the defaults are if you don't actually have that, and anything else that would come up in the usage of your skills. And because GURPS is a point buy system and skills are a benefit, obviously it's going to be something that's going to cost you points. So be aware of that. The harder the skill is, or the more points, the higher level you want the skill to be, that's going to cost you more points. So to start with skills, the first thing you're going to see is you're going to look at skills, and you're going to pick things that, you know, is part of your character concept. And by now, unless you started with skills, which is something for another video, starting at different places in the character creation process, you more than likely are almost done. And you really already kind of have an idea of what your character is going to be like. So you're going to know whether or not you need to take acrobatics or some sort of fighting skill, or if you're going to be some sort of, you know, smart person and you're going to be taking a lot of intelligence-based skills. Which leads me into the controlling attribute section of skills. And essentially what that is that each skill has an attribute that it's part of. It could be, you know, so you remember your attributes are strength, health, dexterity, and IQ. And then there's also two more that could be part of buying your skill, and that's perception and will. It's something more on a rare occasion, but that still is something you need to look at whenever you look at the description of the skill. So your final level is calculated from this. So assume your dexterity is 12, and you decide to buy the acrobatic skill, and you say, I want to roll a 14 or less instead of a 12 or less. So what you'll do is you'll buy the acrobatic skill at a plus 2, and I'll kind of go over that chart here in a minute, and then what that'll have you be able to do is you'll be able to roll 14 or less. Now, someone that actually has it at a higher skill level, oddly enough, means that they're better at it than you are. So just keep that in mind whenever you're purchasing your skills, and sometimes that can actually give you some more insight into actually what your character is, and we'll talk about that. Probably in the next video, I'll talk about more of the non-mechanical side of making a character and the different things that you can do with that, which that video will more than likely be considerably longer. But as far as this stands, this is the end of the mechanics part of creating your character. Also, another thing you look at whenever you're looking at the skill, it's a difficulty level. So there are four difficulty levels. It's easy, average, hard, and very hard, just as they sound. Harder they are, the more points it's going to cost you, because it's harder to learn the skill. You know, it may be easier to learn acrobatics than it would be to learn all these different types of languages and, you know, just different types of skills that require a lot more, you know, a lot more study time or something to that effect, or just more difficult, you know, based on its physicality or its mental state. So just keep that in mind, that the more it's going to cost you more whenever you purchase these skills. And the other thing you look at when you also look at a skill are the prerequisites. So some skills do have prerequisites, but most of them don't. So just but keep in mind that if you do purchase a skill and in the description it says you have to have this other skill, that you must spend at least one point in that prerequisite skill in order to buy this skill that you're looking at. And some, on a rare occasion, you may even need to know the skill at a particular level. So it may say, you know, you can only learn this skill if you had the previous prerequisite skill at a level 13, and you need to have it at that level before you can purchase, regardless how many points that it costs. And that's rare. And then also that's rare is it has to be based on an advantage. So you may have to have a specific advantage in order to get the skill. And again, because there are a lot of skills, and it runs the gamut of many different tech levels, genres, and different types of adventures that your GM may be running, that it is there, but it's pretty rare. So just be aware that you need to read the description of the skill before you actually start throwing points into it, and make sure you have everything that you need in order to purchase that skill. So then we get to the point of what buying the skills. So whenever you buy the skills, you're essentially, there's a chart in there, and it'll actually have your attribute minus, and then an attribute, and then attribute plus. So it's like attribute minus 3, attribute minus 2, attribute minus 1. It's just a little chart, and then you just go across. And if you want to buy something at the attribute level, which in the case of, let's say, you wanted to buy acrobatics, and you just wanted it, like I said, at your 12, and then you'd go and you'd see how hard acrobatics was. And then it's like, let's say that it was, I'm just using an example, I'm not going to look it up real quick, but dexterity average. So then you would go across and you'd say how many points it was. So you'd go down, average, attribute, this direction, which on here probably looks a little different, but you're going to purchase that skill. So it's really easy to tell. And this is the only chart you use, whether it's a dexterity-based skill or it's a perception-based skill, strength, doesn't matter, or whether it's easy, average, hard, or very hard. You're going to see it's a really small chart and it's really easy to understand. So just be aware that there is that particular part of buying skills, and then also the tech level of the skill. So make sure that if you're playing in a fantasy campaign and your GM saying, okay, it's going to be sword and sorcery, you're not going to be purchasing any type of laser weapon skill because that's a higher tech level. So just be aware that you know what the tech level is. Once again, why you should always talk to your GM when you start making characters, so you get an idea of exactly what's expected of you as a player. Now, once you've got your skills and you started kind of deciding what you're going to spend your points on, let's say you finished that part of it. Now you want to know kind of what the skill levels mean and how that's going to play out in the actual adventure. Some people don't necessarily care about this. They just want to buy the skill at a certain level, either based on a character concept or just because they just want it at a level 13 instead of a level 12. But there's also another chart that talks about the probability of success from skill level 3 all the way to skill level 16 plus, and it actually gives you the percentages next to that. So in the case of a skill level 12, 74.1% of the time, you're going to succeed. So if you have a skill level 12 in acrobatics, you're going to succeed that percentage amount of time. So it kind of gives you an idea, you know, how often you're going to succeed. And that can sometimes, you know, dictate, you know, what your character is going to be like. You know, some people like to maybe be making a character that's not really good at certain things, but it's really good at other things. So this kind of helps you out in deciding, you know, how many points to spend. Because remember, because of the difficulty level and you're controlling attribute, you may have, you know, a mental skill at level 12 and a physical skill at level 12, but they may have cost completely different amount of points based on what your attribute was, your dexterity or your IQ. So someone that's really dim-witted and doesn't have a really high IQ is going to find it really hard to start learning skills, you know, about mathematics or tech skills or something like that. And it may, not to say they can't do it, but they would have had to study longer and spend way more points. And as, you know, their life progressed, they would have to spend, you know, a lot more points than someone that was, you know, born, you know, a much smarter and or has a knack for something, then they can actually learn it and spend less points on it. So even though they would have, you know, have similar skill levels. So just be aware that chart there is, you know, for just kind of give you the idea of your probability of success. Now, the last thing you need to know about skills, and I'm just going to go through the basic part of this, is its default. So most skills have a default. So if you don't have acrobatics, it'll say right below it, defaults at minus whatever, I think it's like 4 or 5, minus 4. So if the GM says, hey, Brad, you need to roll against your fighter needs to roll against acrobatics because he's getting ready to fall on the ice. And I'll say, well, I don't have acrobatics. You know, that's the other character. He took that, so I didn't take that. And then he says, okay, well, then what's your dexterity? I tell him, and then we subtract that from the roll, and we subtract whatever its default is from the roll. Now, some skills don't have defaults. Like, there's just no way you can learn those skills at a default. Like, you can't make an attempt at certain skills. And that essentially what that's what it means. You cannot attempt that skill at a specific level. So there's more about skills if you really want to get more realistic, and it talks about more things that are going to happen within the adventure. But the basics of the skills are what I talked about. So it's, you got to know your controlling attribute to the skill, whatever the difficulty level is, if it's got a prerequisite, and then you just purchase the skill, make sure you have the right tech level. And that's pretty much it for the skills. So really, you're just going to thumb through as a player, and you're going to say, I like this skill, like this skill, and then just start buying. So from a technical standpoint, like I said, this is the last part of the videos for that aspect. So, we started with, creating the character as far as, getting your strength and your dexterity, what you looked like, things like that. And then we moved on to other things in the character creation process. And then here at the end, this is where you find out your character is, I would say, pretty much done. And I think in the next video, and maybe a couple, I don't know how, because I think the next video is going to be a little bit longer, because I really want to talk about character concept and starting at different areas when you create your character, because not everybody starts at the very first section of the book. But like I say in all the videos, make sure that you talk to your GM so you know, in the case of skills, exactly what you can and can't have, whether it's cinematic, realistic, that's things you need to know whenever you start buying skills. And then just pick skills that fit your character. And that's really what you need to know. So I hope you've enjoyed this series so far through this part. And like I said, we're almost done. So if you wanna, this is nice. I broke everything up because I really wanted to break it up in these specific sections, because I think it's easier to go back to a section if you really want to know more about it. And once you're going through the book, you'll notice that there are a lot of different things that you can do with your skills. But for right now, if you're just starting out, or you're just really just trying to get your character out there, this is the best way to go about it. Just start with the basics of with the skills and with all of the other parts of your character creation process. So I'm going to see you guys in the next video, and thank you. I really appreciate you watching and commenting on the videos. I've seen comments in other places as well, not just here on YouTube. So I look forward to hopefully seeing you guys make characters, and be interesting to actually see some of you share them. So if you haven't been before to my blog, it's thecheeseshop.org. And as always, down at the bottom, I post a link to Steve Jackson Games, where you can learn everything there is to know about GURPS. And if you can't find it, go to their forums and just post a question. The community there is beyond amazing and awesome. They will help you in many different ways. So look forward to seeing you guys again. Thanks. Bye.